In this video, we will show you how to display collection items in a data grid, edit a record using the inline editing feature, and delete one or several records in one go. In my design, I have a permissions page with a list of users with their name, email, and role. We can select one or more users. We can edit the information for a user or delete a user entirely. In my backend, I have three user endpoints. One to get the list of users, one to edit a user's record, and one to delete the user. In WeWeb, the first thing I'll want to do is display my list of users in a data grid. I will get the data grid element. And when I drop it on my page, I will include the variable just to show you how the data grid works, but I will remove that variable with fake data afterwards. So on my data grid, I can see that the grid data is bound to the data grid fake data variable I just imported. We see our fake data is an array of objects with key value pairs. So our data grid is bound to an array of items. We tell the data grid the unique ID of each item. It could be the email address, but it could be also the ID in our backend, because we know that there will be only one unique ID for each user. And then if we want to add or delete columns in the data grid, we could add a column here and name it. We can choose the type of data we want to display. It can either be a text select, multi-select, or checkbox, or date. This is important if you want to use inline editing. You need to select one of these items. Otherwise, you can choose to drag and drop any custom element. You could have any element here. So you could have a button, for example, and drag and drop it here. The thing is, if you are using a custom element here, it will not be editable with the inline editing feature. In our case, we do want the inline editing mode, so we'll delete this, and in fact we will delete all the columns we don't need. So we don't need a status, we don't need the teams, we only need the name of our users, their role, and email address. In our design, the email is before the role, so we can move the email up. With this type of complex element in WeWeb, the design happens in the specific settings of the element. So you will find that these elements here in the navigator, you won't be able to move them around. That is because the data grid is a complex component built in WeWeb that works in a very specific way. If you need to go full custom, build a full custom table, we recommend using the table element, which is the standard CSS element that you can customize fully. The data grid was built to help you set up inline editing and allow for selection super fast. Now you can still style items inside the data grid. So here is my cell text, for example. Here I can say 14, or I can choose a typography, which I'll do here, which would be a medium text. Same here, medium text, and same here. I can style the headers as well. So heading, say medium, that's a bit too big. Let's say label medium. Yeah, looks good. Label medium and label medium. Now that we know how to use the data grid element, let's use it to display, edit, and delete data from our backend. First, I'm going to clean my project up a little bit. I'm going to remove this binding, delete the unique ID, and delete the fake data grid data that I import in with the element. Now I will bind my data grid to my list of users. So I make sure to bind to the array with my various objects. So I'll bind the array and I will select a unique ID. And here by chance, I don't have to update any of these because they're right. So the path to the name of my user in my collection is indeed name. And email, the path to email is here. And the path to role is indeed role. Now, still on my data grid, I want to update workflows so that when I'm in editing mode, in inline editing mode, when I update, say, Steve to Joyce, right now, not much will happen. It will update my fake data grid data, but I don't want it to do this. I want it on row update. What I want to do is make an API call, an API request to my post endpoint, the endpoint that allows me to edit the record of a user. So /user/user ID. In order to do this, it is indeed a post. So let's say update user record. And the URL will be my base URL plus /user/, and plus. And here I will add the value, the user ID. So this event value is based on the row where the editing workflow was triggered. The fields I need to send are user ID, name, email, role. So user ID I already have, name, email, role. Name, email, role, value, name. It's email. I can just search for it. Email and role. I need authorization headers because this endpoint is protected by authentication. So authorization error access token. Note that setting up API requests on workflows like this, on local workflows, can be a bit of a hassle. That is why we recommend building an API management center upfront at the start when you're building your app. But I can only refer you to the dedicated video on the topic to learn more about this option. For the purposes of this video, I thought it was important to show you how to make that API request. So let's test this. In preview mode, what happens? Let's go to our database. Make sure that I don't have Joyce as a user. So I'm editing Steve, if I remember correctly. And I will validate, see what happens. If I refresh my data here, now Steve has become Joyce. Now I can revert back to Steve. and make sure it's working. Okay, now let's work on the delete workflow. We'll get rid of the workflow that comes with the element. And instead, I will make a REST API request. In this case, it will not be a post, it will be a delete. This is what I see here. It's the delete verb. And I don't need any inputs aside from the user ID. So there we go. I need headers. This endpoint is also protected by authentication. And now let's create a fake item in my database, a fake user, fake. So it's ID 7, and I will refetch my collection in WeWeb to make sure it's displayed. And now let me try this, deleting the user. Nothing is happening in WeWeb, but if I go back to Xano, the user will have disappeared. Why is that change not reflected in WeWeb? Because I need to make sure that after deleting the user, I refetch my list of users, my users collection. Let's create a new fake user, ID 8. And now let's refetch the collection to display it here. And now in preview mode, when I delete it in WeWeb, it disappears from WeWeb and from Xano. Now we've seen how to use the inbuilt workflows of the data grid to edit or delete single items. Let's see if we can figure out how to select multiple items to delete several items at the same time. On my data grid, in the specific settings, I've made sure that I've selected allow selection. So this can be off and there are no checkboxes, or it can be on. And then you have checkboxes and you can select multiple users. For example, here I've added 3 fake users to my Xano database, and we'll figure out how to delete them. We might want to add a delete all button. Let's put it here and say delete selected users. For the purposes of this video, I don't care about the design. I'll just have it here. Now on this button, I will create a workflow, but I will get it from here. So I will copy the delete workflow I have on my data grid and paste it on the button. And so on the click of the button, I will delete a user or users. And here, before the API request, I will add a for loop, iterator for loop. And the items to parse will be a component variable that comes with the data grid. When you add the data grid on a page, you have an array variable called selected rows. And here you see we have 3 items, 0, 1, 2. Which correspond to fake user 2, fake user 3, and fake user 1. So the 3 rows that I have currently selected. This variable is updated automatically with that allow selection setting on the data grid. So we don't have to worry about that. All we have to worry about is we have to say loop through selected rows and bind here to our array. And now for each row, we will make a REST API request. We can get rid of this one. And now, instead of binding to the event value, which will be undefined, we'll need to bind to something that relates to the loop. Except before we can bind to anything inside the loop, we need to test our workflow. So a good sign is that the loop is iterating 3 times, which is a good sign because we did select 3 rows, but we do get an error message. However, now when we go to our API request, we can get rid of the event value ID, and we now have information about the item that was looped through. So here is the list of items that we looped through, the 3 items we looped through. And this is the current item of the loop with the ID, the user ID, which we can also find here, by the way. But in our case, we have it here, the user ID here. So now the first time it iterates through our loop, it will delete user number 10, and then it will go through the loop again and delete user 11, and so on and so forth. So let's try testing this workflow again. There we go. First API request deleted user 10. Second API request, you deleted user 11. Third API request, deleted user 9. And finally, we refetched our user collection. So back on my WeWeb page, I no longer have the fake users. And if I refresh my Xano database, those fake users are gone. There's one last step to add to our workflow to ensure that it works at all times. Back in WeWeb, before we fetch our collection, we will reset our selected rows. So what this will do is that after we have looped through our list of selected rows and deleted the items, we will reset our selected rows variable, so bring it back to its default value, which is an empty array. That way, in preview mode, if we add a couple of new fake users 5, fake user 4, if we try this now, let's look at our variable, component variable from the component selected rows. So fake user 4, fake user 5. And now we will delete our selected users, which will loop through this, reset this variable to an empty array, and then refetch our collection with our updated list of users. There we go. That's it. That's how you use the data grid element in WeWeb to display, edit, or delete one or multiple items at the same time.